Hi guys, my name is Yash Sharma and today I will explain the experiment number 4 of Mass Transfer Lab, and that experiment is loading and flooding characteristic in a packed bed column. So first of all, we need to understand what are the objectives we have with this experiment. So the first objective is to determine the loading and flooding velocity of air water system in a packed tower, and the second objective is to plot a log graph of del P by L versus G, where del P by L is the pressure gradient and G is the mass velocity of air. Third one is to compare the experimentally found out values of flooding velocity with those we will find out by theoretical means, like from Sherwood plot. So let us start the whole thing with the introduction. So first of all, we are using packed bed tower to conduct this experiment. And this packed bed tower is filled with the packing called racing rings, which has internal diameter of 1.25 centimeter. You will find the details in the manual of that. Now, packed bed tower are used for continuous contact of liquid and gas in a vertical column. So in sieve plate or any plate type contractors or column, the contact is not continuous. So that's why packed bed are preferred, where we need continuous contact between gas and liquid. So now what happens? The liquid trickling down to the packed bed from the above side and expose a large surface for a contact with the gas. And by that large surface area, because of that large surface area, the mass transfer is enhanced. And that is our goal, is when we design any equipment regarding in which our aim is to have a separation. So we try to enhance the separation. So by exposing a large surface area of liquid to the gas, we enhance the mass transfer. So now coming to the theory and calculation. So what happens in this column? The liquid, it will wet the surface of the packing from coming from the above side, and then gas pass across to that wetted surface. As I previously described, that it will provide a large surface area. So in this manner, it provides the larger surface area to the gas to have contact with liquid. And when the contact happens, there is a mass transfer. And constituent from gas comes to liquid, or either constituent from liquid comes to gas. And hence, we achieve the mass transfer or separation. So now the question arises, why we are doing this experiment? Why we are trying to calculate the loading and flooding velocity? So when we design any column, the main thing for column is column diameter or its height. So we need to know what is the gas velocity or limiting gas velocity at which we will operate. Because if we will increase the gas velocity, the resistant will be encountered by the downflowing liquid is higher. Okay, it will encounter higher resistance, so it will increase the pressure drop logically. And if the pressure drop or the pressure is higher, it will crush and damage the packing. So it will be loss for us. So that's why we need to know the operating gas velocity at which we can operate. So the pressure drop will not be that high that it will crush the packing. So that's why we conduct this experiment. Now we need to understand what is flooding and loading actually is. So with the help of this graph, I will make you understand what flooding and loading is and how we are going to conduct the experiment in earlier slides, in the upcoming slides. So what flooding and loading is? If you can see this graph is plotted between del P by Z. Z is nothing but the height, you can take it as L also, and log G. G is the gas mass velocity of air in our case, because gas is air in our case. So if you remember, the second objective was to plot this graph. So by experiment, we're gonna plot this graph. But first we will try to understand this graph and trying to understand what flooding and loading means. So if you can see, there is a line for dry packing. Okay, line A. And as you can see, this line is a linear variation of pressure drop across the column with increasing gas velocity. Here we are increasing the gas velocity and we are having a linear variation of pressure drop when we put liquid flow rate 0. Okay, now let us say I will have a constant liquid flow rate. Any value you can take, it should be constant. And we will keep on increasing the gas velocity. Okay. So as you can see, as we increase the gas velocity, from B to C, there is a linear variation. Okay. It is something like dry packing. Why it is? Because at that time, there is not much liquid holdup is there. Okay. So because there is not much liquid holdup, it will behave like a dry packing, but slight increase in the pressure drop happens because there is something, some liquid is there. Okay. Now, if you can see, there is a sharp increase. There is a change in slope from C to D. Okay. As we increase the G. So here liquid is starting to getting stuck or accumulate. That is what called load of liquid. So that's why this point is called loading point. And the velocity of gas corresponding to this point is called loading velocity. When first the slope of our graph will change, that is loading point. Here liquid is starting to getting stuck in the column. Okay. Now, as you can see, from point C to D to E, there is a sharp increase in the pressure drop. Now the amount of liquid is greater amount of liquid is being holded up there. Okay. So it was the packing voids are filling with the liquid totally. And when the point E comes, if we further on keep on increasing the gas velocity, there is another sharp increase in the pressure drop. And that point, every void of the packing is filled and the liquid will not come out from the bottom side. And the gas will going to flow. And hence, at that point, the pressure drop is very high. Pressure drop becomes high. As you can see from the graph also, there is a sharp increase. So that E point is called flooding point, and that condition is called flooding. And when it happens, the gas velocity at which this happens is called flooding velocity at that particular liquid flow rate. So this graph is presented for different liquid flow rates. Okay. And this is what we also do for our experiment. Now you have the understanding how the packed bed works and what is flooding is and what loading is and how, why we want to calculate the flooding and loading velocity and how it works. Okay. Now we can perform the experiment as you know the basic principles. So this is the experimental setup that we use in our lab to conduct this experiment. As you can see in this experimental setup, we have a column filled with the rescinding, as I said previously, with an internal diameter of 1.25 centimeter. So it's our column. Here the mass transfer or the separation process takes place. And here is the pump by which we will the flow of liquid will take place. And here is the blower from where the flow of air or gas will take place. And here is the manometer by which we will measure the pressure drop. It's a U-tube manometer filled with water. So by this, we'll measure the pressure drop across this column. Okay. And here is another manometer by which we will measure the pressure drop of orifice placed attached to this blower so that we can get the flow rate of gas. Okay. So first, what we do, as we have seen in the graph that I have shown in the previous slide, first you do a dry run, means you will put the liquid flow rate to be zero. Okay, there is no liquid flow rate, only gas is flowing. You keep on increasing the gas flow rate. You have a regulator. Okay, so by that regulator, you keep on increasing the gas flow rate and see when the pressure drop of the column becomes constant. And you note that pressure drop value and you note the pressure drop of the orifice plate at the same time. And you have the reading of the pressure drop across the orifice plate and pressure drop across the column. Okay. That is, you know, the principle of manometer, the pressure drop is represented as a difference in height. So you know that difference in height, you multiply it with density and gravity, you get the pressure drop. Okay. So that is about dry run. Now, with the help of this rotameter, what you do, you put a constant liquid flow rate, say any value 27 cc per second, you have put it. Okay, so that liquid will flow rate will be there, and you maintain that constant liquid flow rate as I explained. Now you keep on increasing the gas flow rate and see when the flooding happens, means the pressure drop across the columns becomes constant. And you note that value, or you can see that there is a high liquid holdup. If you are increasing the gas velocity, keep on increasing the gas velocity, liquid will not come from the bottom side, and there you just measure the both the pressure drop as I explained earlier and note the reading. You will repeat this experiment for different flow rate of water and get the reading. You will have a reading of both the pressure drops, and you can note those reading. And now you have the pressure drop of this manometer, that is del P. You divide it with the length of the column, you get del P by L. So one y axis you get, take a log of it, y axis you get. Now here you have this del H, you can convert it into del P, and by that del P of orifice meter, you can measure the gas flow rate. And how we will measure the gas flow rate or the gas mass velocity, let us see in the next slide. So to calculate G, we apply this formula for the velocity of orifice plate. Here CD and beta is there, and there is a del P, which is nothing but the pressure drop of that orifice plate that we have measured, and rho f is the density of fluid. So CD is 0.61, it is given, and beta is 0.5. Now by using this, we can calculate the V, and you know we are using water and air to conduct the experiment, so density you can fill according to that. And the by calculating this V, we have everything now, so you can calculate this V. So by calculating V, you can convert that V into mass velocity, because it's just a velocity. To convert it into a mass velocity, we need to multiply it with the density of air, because the gas is air. Though the dimension, the L, we need to have the height of the column, that is 26.8 centimeter. By dividing the pressure drop of column or pressure drop across the column by this length, you get the del P by L, that is y axis of our graph. So now you have this G for different flow rate, you have del P by L for different flow rates, you can plot a graph. And by that graph, as I explained, you can find out the loading and flooding point, and hence the loading and flooding velocity corresponding to those points. Now, the third objective which we need to fulfill is to compare the experimentally found out value of flooding and loading to that of theoretically found out values by Sherwood plot. So you can refer to this page number of Trebol, and here you have your Sherwood plot, and you can measure the velocity at different flow rates and compare them with the experimentally found out values, and you can calculate the error, and you can describe why those errors are there and how can you rectify them. So this is the end of experiment. Thank you very much for the listening.